session, we are discussing about reactions of alkyl halides, especially substitution reactions. Alkyl halides will undergo substitution of the alkyl group with different other groups to generate or to introduce different function groups in a molecule. We can replace alkyl group with different other groups to generate different function groups. So here alkyl halide is reacted with alcoholic potassium hydroxide to give alcohol plus alkyl potassium halide. Here halide function group is replaced with another function group. So halide is replaced with hydroxy. Similarly, we can replace halide with different other function groups. Okay, then usually if carbon is attached to halogen or any hetero atom, there will be an electronegativity difference between these two atoms, or any hetero atom may happen. So that generally if it is attached to halogen, as halogen having more electronegativity, a partial positive charge will be developed towards carbon because the bond pair will be shifted towards halogen. So here a partial negative charge. So carbon having partial positive and halogen having partial negative. And here this halogen is leaving, and we can introduce another negative charged group or group which is having a positive center, otherwise we will call it as nucleophile. So one positive center loving group is introduced here in the expense of another group. So it is actually substitution. One nucleophile or positive charge loving group is replaced with another group. And this substitution reaction is thoroughly studied in 1935 by Haggas and Ingold. We can consider different halides. Here we are considering primary alkyl halide. Here we are considering a tertiary alkyl halide. We know that methyl groups having inductive effect, so it will donate electron density towards attached carbon. Here we are having three methyl groups. Okay, we know that carbon and halogen having electronegativity difference, and here partial positive charge is developed in this carbon. Here also same carbon halogen bond. Here also partial positive charge is developed here. We can explain the substitution reaction with the help of polarity, steric factor, or activation energy factor. In the basis of polarity, we can consider the polar nature of these two carbons. Here, in this carbon, a partial positive charge is here, that is compensated by one carbon, inductive effect of one carbon only. Here, in this carbon, its positive charge is compensated by three other carbons' inductive effects. So, if you are considering the charge density here, positive charge density here, this carbon having more positive tendency than this one, because this carbon's positive charge is compensated by inductive effect of these three carbons. At the same time, here only one carbon is there to compensate the positive charge of this one. So this positive charge density is considerably reduced compared to this one. So if any hydroxy group is approaching, suppose OH minus is approaching here, here also OH minus is approaching, that means this negative group will feel more positive tendency here compared to this one. So this hydroxy group having more tendency to approach here than this position. That explanation we can give based on polarity. Then another one is steric factor. Steric factor. Here this carbon is tetrahedrally attached to, or this is tetrahedron, in this is a tetrahedral structure, and this carbon is attached to four other groups. Out of that one is a methyl or alkyl group, and two other groups are just small hydrogens. But in this case, we are not considering a halogen because these two are same. But in this case, it is also a tetrahedron, but this carbon, suppose this carbon, it is attached to three other groups, methyl groups. Here, two small hydrogens there, that is replaced by two other bulky groups. That means this carbon is killing more steric crowding than this carbon. So if an incoming hydroxy group is coming here, or incoming hydroxy group is coming here, which position it can approach easily? Here the steric factor is less, so accommodation of a fifth group is easy here, but here the steric factor is extremely high. Now itself it is extremely high, so it is very difficult to accommodate a newly coming group. So steric factor can explain a steric hindrance there. Here approach of hydroxy group is hindered by steric factor, so it is steric hindrance is happening here. Then another factor is activation energy. Activation energy, in any reaction, a starting material is reacted to form activated complex with higher energy than product. Activated complex is converted to product. If the activation energy barrier is higher, then it is very difficult to overcome. If the activation energy barrier is less, it is easy to overcome a reaction or proceed a reaction. Here, if the fifth group is approaching here and fifth group is approaching here, because of the steric crowding, activation energy factor is high, will be higher here. Here the activation energy factor will be less. So approach of hydroxy group is favored here if we are considering activation energy factor. Here hydroxy group, approach of hydroxy group is entirely difficult. So in order to substitute halide by hydroxy group in a primary alkyl halide, and substitution of halide with hydroxy group in a tertiary alkyl halide, we should propose two different mechanisms, because the charge density is different here, that means polarity is different here, then steric factor is different there, then activation energy factor is also different. So we should propose different mechanism for these two reactions. So here the approach is agreeable, but here the approach by a fifth group in order to form a trigonal bipyramidal arrangement, or the tetrahedron, change of tetrahedron to trigonal bipyramid is difficult here, but it is comparatively easy here. So that means formation of such, our approach of hydroxy group at the same time and the formation of five attached groups around this carbon is very difficult. So we should propose a different mechanism for that one. Here we can proceed through the same mechanism. Okay, here the mechanism is written here, that was proposed by Huygens and Ingold. Here alkyl halide is there, partial positive and partial negative. Here the hydroxy group is approaching here, and it is a slow process, so you will get an activated complex here. The activated complex is forming here. Here it is not difficult. It is a trigonal bipyramidal system. Trigonal bipyramidal system will form here. Trigonal bipyramidal. Three groups in this triangle and two other groups. So totally five groups is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, and fifth group is there. This structure, trigonal bipyramidal structure, is there. Then that will undergo dissociation very fast to give alcohol. That means a X is replaced with OH. And here in this process, this is the slowest step. If you are considering the rate of the reaction, that is proportional to concentration of substrate. RX, alkyl halide is the substrate, that and concentration of incoming group, because only because of the incoming group, this halide is expelled. So both are involved in this reaction step, and we can represent that one as it is a substitution reaction. We can have this S, then if it is towards a positive sender, so it is nucleophilic towards a positive sender, loving a positive sender. So substitution nucleophilic and involves, and rate determining step, the slowest step or the rate determining step involves two, substrate and nucleophile. So it is bimolecular. So SN2, substitution nucleophilic bimolecular. And another one proposed for, that is proposed for this primary alkyl halide. For tertiary alkyl halide, we can have a different mechanism, because approach by OH minus at the same time is difficult. So what is happening? The tertiary alkyl halide will cleave by itself to give a stable carbocation, and the tertiary carbocation is more stable. It is favored by this factor also. Tertiary carbocation is more stable compared to secondary, and that is more stable compared to primary. So tertiary alkyl halide will cleave to form a tertiary carbocation, and that tertiary carbocation is, now it is actually a tertiary carbocation, it is trigonal planar, it is a plane, trigonal planar structure. So it is a planar structure, trigonal planar structure. This carbocation is trigonal planar, and then the position is free. Now hydroxy group and approach attached there, so it will form alcohol. Here, if you are considering the rate of reaction, it is proportional to, rate of reaction is proportional to concentration of substrate, because the rate determining step, that is the slowest step, is only depends on alkyl halide. So rate is proportional to concentration of substrate, that is alkyl halide substrate. So we can represent it as substitution nucleophilic monomolecular. Okay, here it is SN2, here it is SN1. So for a primary alkyl halide, substitution reaction will be SN2, and for tertiary alkyl halide, substitution reaction will be SN1. Then, what are the factors that you can influence substitution reactions, means SN1 or SN2 reactions in alkyl halides? First one is substrate. Nature of substrate we have already discussed here. If it is primary or tertiary, that's actually its nature. Attached to carbon halogen bond nature. If it is a primary tertiary carbon or if it is a primary carbon, that depends on that one. The reaction will be SN1 or SN2. That all discussed there. Then the second one, nature of leaving group. Suppose this hydroxy group is approaching here, so this halogen is leaving. So tendency of halide ion to leave that position is very important. We can consider different halides. F- fluoride, chloride, bromide and iodide. If you are comparing the size of these different halides, you can see that a negative charge is embedded in a very small area. That means high charge density. But here the negative charge is embedded in this large area in the case of I minus. So charge density, the charge is distributed in a more area compared to this F minus. Here it is crowded, the charge is crowded in a very small area. Here it is distributed in an entire area. So it's similar to a resonance factor. It is charge is distributed more area, so it is relaxed, system is relaxed, so it is more stable. Otherwise we can say it is more stable, I minus is more stable compared to F minus. So if you are having Halley does I minus or Halley as I minus or F minus, the leaving tendency of I minus will be higher compared to F minus because I minus is more stable. And one more factor is there, I minus is having more size, bulky size. Oh, so expelling I minus will reduce the bulkiness of the system compared to F minus. That also add up the leaving tendency of I minus. So leaving group, that won't explain here. We just consider the examples of different halides. Then incoming group, nucleophilicity. So incoming group, this is actually the incoming group. The tendency of that group to approach the positive center is very important. We can consider different nucleophiles. Here this nucleophile is generated from HF, it is from H2O, it is from NH3 and it is from a stable molecule methane. So if it, suppose the positive center is H+, which nucleophile, which group is having the strongest tendency to approach H+? Just we can, from a glance itself, we can say that CH3 having the highest tendency, because if it is attached to H+, suddenly it will form a stable molecule CH4. But if F- is attached to H+, it will form HF. HF is acidic. HF having tendency to lose its H+. H+ will leave it fast. That means tendency of a molecule, so tendency of this nucleophile to attach to positive center is different. Here CH3 having higher tendency to approach a positive center or attach a positive center compared to F-. So incoming group nucleophilicity is very important. If this is incoming group, certainly it will influence, it will be introduced very easily than F-. Then another factor is solvent polarity. We are having different solvents. For example, water, it is a protic polar solvent. Benzene, aprotic, apolar solvent. Then acetone, aprotic, polar solvent. So we are having different solvent systems there. That solvent system can also influence the progress of SN1 or SN2 reaction. That depends on like dissolves like. For example, here RX, it is cleaving to form. Here a molecule is less polar, but the generated groups are two polar groups, two R+ carbocation and a negative nucleophile. Two polar groups are generated. That means if you are using a polar solvent, that polar solvent will favor the generation of polar group in that one. That means if you are using a polar solvent, it will stabilize the formation of this R+ carbocation, formation of carbocation. So if you are introducing a polar group, polar solvent, polar solvent to this reaction, it will favor the formation of carbocation, because it is a polar solvent, so it will favor the formation of polar units, or it will stabilize this polar intermediates, whether it is transition state or intermediate. If it is stabilized, it will reduce the activation energy of the reaction. So if you are introducing a polar solvent, it will reduce the activation energy of this process, so it will be more easy to progress. Then suppose in this case, here it is OH- a polar group, RX partial positive, partial negative tendency there. So altogether the starting materials are polar. But in this case, what is happening here? the angle is almost 180. Angle is almost 180 means one side polarity x minus. So both side having negative tendency almost similar. So the resultant is, or vector addition will give a resultant polarity less, means nil polarity there. There will be polarity comparatively less than these starting materials. What is what will happen here? If you are using a polar solvent, it will favor the formation of starting material itself, or retaining of starting material will happen. But at the same time, if you are favoring, if you are introducing a non-polar solvent here, the less polar portion will be stabilized. Here it is less polar because negative here, both are negative, that means it will cancel. So net effect is zero. That means this is favored by a non-polar solvent than a polar solvent. Polar solvent will favor the starting material itself. So solvent can also influence the progress of substitution reactions in alkyl halides, whether it is SN1 or SN2. Usually SN1 reaction will be favored by polar solvent and SN2 reaction will be favored by non-polar solvent. Thank you.